Hello friends, welcome to UGC EPG Pathshala. I'm Atika Tajdar from Department of Geography, Jamia Millia Islamia. I'm presenting this module on behalf of Dr. Shubhkanta Mohapatra. Today, we'll have some understanding of climate change, evidences and their causes. We experience or hear about intense storms, frequent floods, severe droughts, melting and receding glacier, etc. And the list goes on. You might have also read or heard that climate change is being cited as the major reason for such extreme events. For several years, global warming or climate change was considered as skeptics' argument. But today, it has been accepted as a reality. This was possible due to the significant contribution made by various scientists engaged in climate science research. Since the information of intergovernmental panel on climate change, which is also called IPCC, a concerted effort has been made to compile researches conducted across the globe on human-induced climate change. Till now, IPCC has produced 5 assessment reports that provide latest scientific advancement in this area. This has also provided guidelines for policymaker for future. In this module, we shall study climate change and describe various natural as well as human-induced factors responsible for climate change. This would be followed by corroborating scientific evidences about human-induced climate change. We will also discuss about the probable consequences and impact of climate change both at global as well as at national level. After reading this module, you will be able to define climatic change, explain natural and human-induced factors responsible for climate change, describe various evidences of climate change and their sources, describe the adverse impact of human activities on climate change, and analyze the probable consequences and impact of climate change at global as well as national level. Definition of climate change. In simple terms, climate change may be expressed as any substantial change in Earth's climate that lasts for an extended period of time. Normally, minimum 30-year time period are being considered for analyzing or predicting any climate condition of a place. Two major elements of climate are temperature and precipitation. According to the Intergovernmental Panel on climate change refers to any change in climate over time, whether due to natural variability or a result of human activity. The United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change in Article 1 defined it as, climate change refers to a change in climate which is attributed directly or indirectly to human activity that alters the composition of the global atmosphere and which is in addition to natural climate variability observed over comparable time period. Now we'll discuss global change and climate change. Today, there are a lot of discussion on global change issues rather than merely discussing about climate change. While talking about climate change, there is a need for a discussion on global change for two reasons. First one is climate change is among many global changes that has been affecting the earth. And the second one is climate change has been affecting and has been affected by many of the global change phenomena. Global change is a transformation that occurs on a worldwide scale, which is an increase in carbon dioxide in the atmosphere or exhibits sufficient cumulative effect to have worldwide impact. Example, local species extinction resulting in global loss of biodiversity. In the past, the main drivers of global change have been solar output, plate tectonic, volcanism, proliferation, and abatement of life, resource depletion, changes in Earth's orbit around the Sun, and changes in the tilt of Earth on its axis. There is increasing evidence that now the main driver of global change is the growing human population's demand for energy, food, goods and services, and disposal of its waste product. In the last 250 years, global change has caused climate change, widespread species extinction, fish stock collapse, desertification, ocean acidification, ozone depletion, pollution, and other large-scale shifts. Sources of climate change. Do you know that climate change had happened many a time on the Earth's history since its origin? Then you must be thinking that why we are making so much hue and cry about this. This is because climate change in today's context is anthropogenic, or in simpler term, created by human activities. Evidences suggest that earlier climate change occurred due to natural processes. Therefore, in the beginning of the module, we will discuss briefly about the various natural sources responsible for climate change during different geological periods of the Earth's history. We will also discuss in detail climate change due to anthropogenic activity that have been taking place in the recent times. The sources or the causes for the climate change could be grouped into two. First is natural and second is anthropogenic. Natural sources of climate change. Some of the factors mentioned below are responsible for long-term climate change, whereas others are responsible for the short-term climate change. Major natural sources of climate change are solar variability, changes in Earth's orbit and tilt, plate tectonic and biological evolution. Let us discuss briefly above mentioned factor one by one. Solar variability. This happened due to the variation in solar energy output. You might have read that the energy output of the sun varied slightly over time. This has been measured by the data obtained through satellite. The variation in the total output has been observed both throughout the day as well as during the solar cycle. This variation can directly affect Earth's climate, but the exact role that solar variability plays is still a controversial and not unanimously accepted by the scientific community. Now, change in Earth's orbit and tilt. This was another major natural sources responsible for climate change. You might have read that the Earth generally changes its orbit over 100,000 year cycle. It normally shifts from almost a circular to elliptical orbit. This has led to changes in the tilt of Earth's axis between 21.8 and 24.4 degree, as a result of which there has been change in the planet's solar energy budget. In other words, there used to be a change in the amount of solar radiation that different areas of Earth receive. The northern hemisphere is now closer to the sun in winter and farther away in summer, as a result of which it received 5% less sunlight in summer than 12,000 years ago. More tilt led to greater seasonal variation. This is known as Milankovic cycle. Milankovic was a Serbian geophysicist and astronomer who theorized this above mentioned phenomena. Plate tectonic. As a geography student, you might have read about the continental drift and plate tectonic theory in your course on physical geography, or specifically in geomorphology. As described by both the theories, millions of years ago, most of the Earth's landmass was a single continent known as Pangaea and surrounded by one huge water body mass known as Panthalas. Over time, portion of it drifted apart, gradually forming the continent and ocean basins existing today. The redistribution of landmass and ocean area has had a major effect on global climate. Biological evolution. This natural process took place mainly during the evolution of photosynthetic organism. Do you know that several billion years ago, Earth's pre-life atmosphere was mainly covered by carbon dioxide and methane? The gradual shift in the atmospheric concentration from carbon dioxide and methane to nitrogen and oxygen took place because photosynthetic organism consumed carbon dioxide and generated oxygen. Climate change due to anthropogenic activities. As mentioned in the beginning of the module, today's climate change is primarily due to the anthropogenic activities. But do you know that how we have arrived on such conclusion? There was a lot of scientific research that took place over the last 200 years that helped in concluding about the present climate change is due to anthropogenic activities. Let us discuss these scientific developments in brief. Scientific study to establish human-induced climate change. As we know, today's climate change is due to the presence of excessive greenhouse gases in the atmosphere due to human activities. This led to increase in temperature on the Earth's surface due to greenhouse effect. Do you know the scientist who identified the problem created by greenhouse effect? The French mathematician Joseph Fourier, who highlighted the greenhouse effect. Fourier realized that the Earth's temperature is determined not only by the radiation absorbed by and emitted from the Earth, but also by the existence of the atmosphere. The atmosphere absorbs some of the radiated heat and act as a blanket over the earth that maintain the temperature higher than it would otherwise be. The next major breakthrough was made in 1860 by the British scientist John Tyndall in terms of measuring the absorption of radiation by different gases. This led to a remarkable discovery that the most prevalent gases in the atmosphere are oxygen and nitrogen were not absorbing any of the energy at all. Only the minor gases in the atmosphere, which are carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide and water vapor, were doing so. These gases are called greenhouse gases. The Swedish scientist Svante Arrhenius was the first person to estimate the extent to which increases in atmospheric carbon dioxide increase Earth's surface temperature. This is also known as Arrhenius effect. Presently, studying climate system is much more advanced due to the advancement in information and communication technology aided by space technology, global warming and anthropogenic activities. Till now, you might have realized that global warming is most commonly associated with human interference, specifically the release of excessive amount of greenhouse gases. These gases act like greenhouse around the earth. This means that these gases allow the heat from the sun to enter into the atmosphere but do not allow the heat to escape back into space. In other words, more increase in the greenhouse gas, the larger is the percentage of heat trapped inside the Earth's atmosphere. You might be knowing that the Earth would not have been inhabitable without the presence of some naturally occurring greenhouse gases. This is because without these gases, no heat would be trapped in the atmosphere. So the Earth would be extremely cold. It is estimated that the average temperature of the Earth would be about 170 degrees Celsius without greenhouse effect, which is not at all the condition for the growth of biota. Naturally occurring greenhouse gases, which are not fluorinated gases, are good in naturally occurring amounts. It's when people start contributing excessive amount of these that greenhouse gases become a problem. With excessive greenhouse gas buildup, the Earth's atmosphere warmed to unnatural temperatures. Let us understand how various human activities contribute in increasing these greenhouse gases. How do human activity contribute to climate change? Different anthropogenic activity lead to emissions of four principal greenhouse gases: carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, and the halocarbons, a group of gases containing fluorine, chlorine and bromine. These gases accumulate in the atmosphere and have been increasing with the passage of time. The most significant aspect about the increases in all of these gases is that they have occurred in the industrial era, which is not more than 300 years old. This is because of the influence of human activity, particularly in the recent centuries. It is so significant that it has been affecting all the living organisms on the earth. Carbon dioxide has been increasing from the utilization of fossil fuel in transportation, building, heating or cooling and in the manufacture of cement and other goods. Deforestation releases CO2 and reduces its uptake by plants. Carbon dioxide is also released in natural processes such as the decay of plant matter. Methane has increased as a result of human activities related to agriculture, natural gas distribution and landfills. Methane is also released from the natural processes that occur, for example, in wetlands. Nitrous oxide is emitted by human activity such as fertilizer use and fossil fuel burning. Natural processes in soil and the ocean also release nitrous oxide. Halocarbon gas concentration have increased primarily due to human activities. Principal halocarbon include the chlorofluorocarbon, which were used extensively as refrigeration agents and in other industrial processes before their presence in the atmosphere was found to cause a stratospheric ozone depletion. We will discuss in detail about these gases and their major sources in the next module, which exclusively discuss about the role of human being on climate change. Sources of evidence about climate change. When we discuss about the science of climate change, we generally look for evidences and causes responsible for climate change, as a result of which the scientific community, including geographers, look for three key elements. These three key elements are the study of past climate, the measurement of current climate change and the modeling and projection of future climate scenario. Scientists all over the world have been systematically compiling and analyzing different climate related parameters to ascertain about the changing climate. They have also made an attempt to ascertain that the present climate change to human induced. The IPCC, since its inception in 1988, has been working as the international scientific organization coordinating global climate change research, climate forecast and policy formulation by engaging collaboration of scientists and policy experts from many disciplines across the globe. Therefore, this assertion is based on certain fact rather than any speculation or politically motivated. Some of the sources of evidences are as follows. Evidences of climate change. Climate scientists have been constantly engaged in gathering information on key parameters of climate that indicate that some of these parameters have been unequivocally reflect warming of climate. These evidences are gathered from various sources from last 100 years as well as in extensive details for the last 2 to 3 decades. Various sources used for gathering such information are innumerable weather stations across the globe, satellites, ship, aircrafts, weather balloons and bios. These evidences are collated and trend analysis has been undertaken by numerous scientists engaged at national and international level. At the international level, these researches are compiled and global trend have been reported by the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, which is also called IPCC, in the form of assessment report. IPCC, since its origin in 1988, has already been published 3 assessment reports. So far, 5 reports have been published in chronological order. The latest 5th assessment report have been published between September 2013 and April 2014. As mentioned above, there are certain parameters that provide indication of warming of climate. Some of these indicators are as follows. Increasing temperature over land and ocean surfaces, melting of glacial ice and sea ice, rising sea level and increasing humidity. Let us have detailed discussion on these indicators of climate change in the following section. Increasing temperature over land and ocean surface. If we analyze temperature data in terms of hemisphere since 1880, it has been observed that the years with the warmest land surface temperature were 2005 and 2010 in the northern hemisphere. In the southern hemisphere, 2009 was the warmest. It has also been observed that the period from 2000 to 2010 was the warmest decade since 1880. The data from long-term climate reconstruction of temperature point to the present time as the warmest in the last 120,000 year. These reconstruction also suggests that the increase in temperature during the 20th century is extremely likely within a confidence interval of greater than 95% to 100%, the largest to occur in any century over the past 1000 years. Record setting summer daytime temperature are being recorded in many countries. According to National Oceanic Administration of America, ocean temperatures has also been rising. According to NOAA, sea surface temperature increased at an average rate of 0.07 degrees Celsius per year from 1901 to 2012 as ocean absorb atmospheric heat. This rise is reflected in measurement of upper ocean heat content, which include the upper 700 meter of ocean. Melting of glacial and sea ice. You might have read in the newspaper, magazine or heard from TV, radio, etc. that glacier in Greenland and Antarctica have been receding due to the fast rate of melting. Is this a fact? If yes, what are the reasons responsible for such situations? As discussed in the previous paragraph that there has been increases in surface temperature both at land and sea, this rise in temperature had a direct relationship with the melting of glacial ice and sea ice. As temperature rise in Earth's atmosphere, glaciers are losing ice mass, shrinking in size. This process is known as glacial retreat. Earth's 2 largest ice sheets in Greenland and Antarctica are also losing ice mass. This is evident from the satellite record. Analysis of satellite data of July 2012 revealed that 97% of the ice sheet's surface was melting. This was the greatest extent in the 30-year record of satellite measurement. Another analysis related to summer melt of the Greenland ice sheet has also revealed that it has increased 30% from 1979 to 2006. On the basis of these evidences, scientists now estimate that between 1 and 2/3 of Arctic permafrost will thaw over the next 200 years. As you know, these permafrost reserves took thousands of years to form. Similar kind of observation has also been noticed in relation to sea ice. Maximum sea ice cover in the world is found in the Arctic Sea. The extent of Arctic sea ice varies over the course of a year. Every summer, some amount of sea ice thaws, whereas in winter, the ice refreezes. It has been observed with the help of satellite data that the minimum extent of summer sea ice occurs in September, whereas maximum extent of winter sea ice occurs in the month of February or early March. However, analysis of satellite data reveal that this has declined since 1977. September sea ice is declining at a rate of 11% per decade in comparison to the 1979 to 2000 average and reached its lowest extent in the modern record in 2012. The accelerating decline of summer sea ice in association with record losses of sea ice in 2007 and 2012 suggests that summer sea ice may disappear sooner than predicted by most models. Some scientists have also estimated an ice-free summer Arctic Ocean within the next few decades. Rising sea level. This is another important indicator of climate change. It has been observed that sea level is rising more quickly than the prediction is simulated by most of the climatic model. During the last century, sea level rose from 17 to 21 centimeter. However, this rise is not uniform across the globe. A greater rise has been observed in some areas like Atlantic coast of US than at any time during the past 2000 years. How did the scientists arrive at such conclusion? Do you have any idea about the tools used for assessing the rise in sea level? Generally, we use tidal gauges and satellite to generate such kind of data. Tidal gauge records from 1901 to 2010 show that sea level rose at a rate of 1.7 mm per year. Satellite data for the period 1993 to 2013 show that sea level rose 3.16 mm per year. This rise is primarily due to two major factors that are presently contributing to sea level rise. About 2/3 of the rise comes from the melting of glacier and ice sheets, whereas the rest 1/3 comes from the thermal expansion of seawater due to absorption of atmospheric heat and expand in volume. Increasing humidity and extreme events. It has been observed that global average specific humidity has increased by about 0.1 gram of water vapor per kilogram of air per decade since 1973. This change is consistent with rising air temperature since warm air has greater capacity to absorb water vapor. A great amount of water vapor in the atmosphere affects weather in number of ways and can lead to extreme event evolving temperature, precipitation and storm intensity. According to the World Meteorological Organization, the decade from 2001 to 2010 showed evidence of worldwide increase in extreme events, notably heat waves, increased precipitation and floods. However, to establish a strong linkage between trends related to extreme weather and climate change required data for a longer time frame than what is now available. These above mentioned changes have differential impacts in terms of geographical locations, sector of economy and socio-economic groups. Therefore, some of the major impacts or consequences of climate change are mentioned for two levels. One is at macro level, which is at global level, and other is at the micro level, which is at national level. Some of the major observations of 5th assessment report in 2013 by IPCC are observation of climate change in global level. Some of the highlights of the 5th assessment report are as follows. First one is each of the last 3 decades has been successively warmer at the Earth's surface than any preceding decade since 1850. Ocean warming dominates the increase in energy stored in the climate system, accounting for more than 90% of the energy accumulated between 1971 and 2010. Further uptake of carbon by the ocean will increase ocean acidification. Third is over the last 2 decades, the Greenland and Antarctic ice sheets have been losing masses. Glaciers have continued to shrink almost worldwide. And Arctic sea ice and northern hemisphere spring snow cover have continued to decrease in extent. Fourth is the rate of sea level rise since the mid-19th century has been larger than the mean rate during the previous two millennia. Over the period of 1901 to 2010, global mean sea level rose by 0.19 meter. Fifth is the atmospheric concentration of the carbon dioxide, methane and nitrous oxide have increased to level unprecedented in at least the last 800,000 year, primarily from fossil fuel emission and secondarily from net land use change emission. The ocean has absorbed about 30% of the emitted anthropogenic carbon dioxide, causing ocean acidification. Sixth is the total radiative forcing is positive and has led to an uptake of energy by the climate system. The largest contribution to total radiative forcing is caused by the increase in the atmospheric concentration of CO2 since 1750. Seventh is the warning of the climate system is unequivocal. Many of the temperature changes observed since the 1950 are unprecedented over decades to millennia. It is extremely likely 95 to 99% that human influence has been the dominant cause of the observed warming since the mid-20th century. Eighth is the climate model have improved since the fourth assessment report. Model reproduce observe continental scale surface temperature pattern and trends over many decades, including the more rapid warming since the mid-20th century and the cooling immediately following large volcanic eruptions. Continued emission of greenhouse gases will cause further warming and changes in all the components of the climate system. Limiting climate change will require substantial and sustained reduction of greenhouse gas emissions. Tenth one is the change in the global water cycle will not be uniform. The contrast in precipitation between wet and dry region and between wet and dry season will increase. 11th is the global mean sea level will continue to rise. The rate of sea level rise will very likely exceed that observed during 1971 to 2010 due to increased ocean warming and increased loss of ice mass from glaciers and ice sheets. Observation of changes in climate at national level. In India, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change is the nodal agency which has been sending reports to UNFCCC. Till now, it has already sent two reports titled as India's first and second national communication to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change in 2004 and 2012 respectively. Let us discuss briefly about these two reports. First is the future impact of climate change identified by governments of India's national communications. In 2004 include the decreased snow cover affecting snow-fed and glacial systems such as the Ganges and Brahmaputra. About 70% of the summer flow of the Ganges comes from meltwater. Erratic monsoon with serious effect on rain-fed agriculture, peninsular rivers, water and power supply. Drop in wheat production by 4-5 million tons with even a 1 degree rise in temperature. Rising sea level causing displacement along one of the most densely populated coastline in the world, threatened freshwater sources and mangrove ecosystems. Increased frequency and intensity of floods. Increased vulnerability of people in coastal arid and semi-arid zone of the country. Studies indicate that over 50% of India's forests are likely to experience shift in forest type, adversely impacting associated biodiversity, regional climate dynamic as well as livelihood based on forest product. Indian Network for Climate Change Analysis, which is also called INCCA, in the recently released report titled Climate Change and India, a 4x4 assessment, a sectoral and regional analysis for 2030s, assess differential impact of on the basis of observed climate change and climate change projection for the year 2030s on selected sectors such as water resources, agriculture, forest and human health of selected four distinct geo-ecological regions of India that are sensitive to climate change. These regions are Himalayan region, Northeastern region, Western Ghat and Coastal region. According to the report, the choice of the sector and region is in conformity with the significance and importance of the climate sensitive sector of the economy that cover the well-being and livelihood of the large population residing in these regions. But the complete extent and level of climate change impact on India are still to be studied because it is very diverse and complex in nature. This is because vulnerability to climate change increases due to low adaptive capacity to withstand the adverse impact of climate change due to high dependence on the majority of the population on climate sensitive sector like agriculture, forestry, poor infrastructure facilities, weak institutional mechanism and lack of financial resources. Now we'll summarize this module by saying that climate change refers to a change in climate which is attributed directly or indirectly to human activity that alter the composition of global atmosphere and which is in addition to natural climate variability observed over comparable time period. Major natural sources of climate change are solar variability, changes in Earth's orbit and tilt, plate tectonic and biological evolution. Various anthropogenic activity lead to emission of four principal greenhouse gases which are carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide and the halocarbons. These gases accumulated in the atmosphere and have increased with the passage of time. The increase in greenhouse gases within a small period of human history is a problem since it has adverse and differential impact on different sector and region. Some of the adverse impact would be melting of ice cap, rise in sea levels, submergence of many island countries and densely populated coastal areas, increasing frequency of extreme weather events, etc. There are certain global parameters that provide indication of climate. There are certain global parameters that provide indication of warming of climate. Some of these indicators are increasing temperature over land and sea surfaces, increasing sea surface temperature and ocean heat content, melting glacial ice and sea ice, rising sea level, increasing humidity and increase in extreme events. In India, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change is the nodal agency which has been sending report to UNFCCC. Till now, it has already sent two reports titled as India's first and second national communication to the United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change in 2004 and 2012 respectively. Thank you.